Okay. We can take a Dr. White cap. Bismillah. Mashallah.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. مفتي, I've been on the line waiting for so long.
Subhanallah. So sorry. You know, we had to just give them a little bit of time. Everyone is equally important, so we try to, yes.
Out. So how is, I don't know, because I mean, I know you a lot compared to the people here, but I'm speechless now. And you know, before you accepted my request, I was like, oh, I'm going to say this, I'm going to say that. But now I'm speechless. I don't know what to say.
Oh, I don't know.
But yeah, but I mean, I want you to tell us, you know, how do you get to cope with the fact that you're able to keep going on? I mean, like, I think the lady before me talked about negative comments and all of that. Yeah, of course, that's inevitable. You explained that. But, you know, how do you get to cope with it? I mean, because, you know, when you look at the society today, it's very toxic. We've got negative people around. We've got, you know, you get what I'm trying to say. So how are you able to keep up with it? Because a lot of people are trying to do what you want to do, but unfortunately, you know, they stop or they just don't go forward with it. You know, you get my point? So yeah, so I mean, just tell us, oh, okay, this is what I'm able to do. This is what keeps me going. This is what motivates me. You know, we want to know, we want to be like you. I mean, you're a very big role model in the society.
No, subhanAllah, no. You see, one thing I believe is very, very important. Mm-hmm. Whatever one does, success or growth of the one's work is important. Mm-hmm. But usually growth takes time.
Mm-hmm.
So first of all, why are you doing the work?
Yes.
It's important.
Very important.
So you have to tell yourself, you see, for example, being a Muslim, primarily you are doing the work for the sake of Allah. So you know Allah sees, Allah knows, Allah is watching, and Allah is happy with what you are doing because it is a good work. So that's one thing that is very important. The second thing I believe is very important is patience and just be consistent and, you know, don't be after followers and don't compare yourself with others.
Mm-hmm.
Don't ever do that. Because you started and you have one view or two views or 10, 20, and others who got in hundreds or thousands of views, then you begin to compare yourself with them. When you begin to do that, you begin to feel discouraged and then you stop the work you are doing. And then you lost out.
Yeah.
So first of all, you are doing your work for the sake of Allah. Secondly, you are patient and be very consistent and don't be after followers or likes or what. Don't be after all that. And then you carry on and you move on. Then the third thing I believe is important is you have to be strong enough not to allow negative comment to affect what you do. So many people are going to come and say negative comments. You're wasting your time. Why should you do this? And why should you do something like this? You know, be yourself. Well, I don't see anything wrong with someone trying to change themselves to become better people. So, for example, your friends knew you to be someone who wasn't very religious or pious or doing good things. And then suddenly, boom, you changed. So they start, you claiming pious, like how they do, subhanAllah, in Nigeria.
That's the
they that's... Sometimes, I'm not trying to, you know, it's common not only in Nigeria, but I've seen in Nigeria. That's why I'm mentioning. How they do, when you begin to, for example, adjust your English to become better in the way you speak, then they start phone and things like, you know what's happening?
You're a good example. You know, because when you look back then, firstly, you talked about why do you want to do it? Because you believe, I mean, you're doing it for a sole purpose, right? Not because of people, because you want to share the message, which is very important. And then you have to be patient. And then lastly, you talk about being strong because of the influence or negative influence of the society. I mean, because, you know, you talked about you shouldn't do things because of your followers. I mean, for me to look at you, for example, like I said, you're a very big role model in the society globally, because, you know, we've got people coming from Italy, from Congo, from different places right now, and they're much more. But what I'm just trying to say, you know, I mean, to be honest, when you look back at perhaps when you started, you know, back then, we're like, Mufti. You know, it was a bit of followers. And today, mashallah, alhamdulillah, you have, I don't recall the YouTube, but at least you, on TikTok, you have over 100,000 followers. Can you imagine? I mean, just in the span of how many years? So that's the reality of life. I mean, I feel because... Yeah, I mean, you said it all already. You said it all because you, I mean, well, it's not just in Nigeria. I think it's a global thing when you want to do something good, or because you were known as someone who was bad, or perhaps you had friends, or you were in a toxic group or something like that, and you decided, oh, I finally know the truth, or I've decided to stop the bad works I've been doing. I want to be a better person. And if you got people looking at you like, like this person, we knew you. Perhaps you were like the gang leader of this bad group, and then now today you're just coming up, you want to tell us. So, and then one thing I wanted to ask you is, you know, how do you think about what you talk about? I mean, of course, I know you're trying to talk about the deen, share the message, just, yeah, exactly, and then motivate people. But how do you think about the topics you talk about? How do you think about, okay, I'm going to talk about this? What makes you, yeah, how do you think about them? Like, you know, you talk about particular topics, so what makes you think about them? How do you think about it? What's your, you know?
Well, usually in Islam, we are taught you usually talk or preach or teach based on what the society needs.
Mm-hmm.
So if you notice, sometimes I am in Niger, in Mina, I talk different topics. If I go to Abuja, I speak different topics. If I go to Kano, I speak different topics.
Yeah.
And like that. So we are taught usually in Islam, you teach and you talk, you preach based on what the society needs.
Yeah.
So that's how it works. And yeah, I believe that's
it. Okay, yes, so most importantly is just to look at your society. What do they need, right?
Or what they need, yes. Okay. Perhaps you've been talking one or two, three things, and suddenly something comes out or happens which the Ummah or the society needs to be reminded on.
Yeah.
So you can be talking of maybe preaching Salah or preaching some other things, and suddenly something really happens and it has become a crisis, then it would be more proper for you to drop what you are already on, preaching on or teaching usually based on, yes, we said what the society needs. Then you go to the crisis or what suddenly happened, which the society now is in more need of you speaking on that than the usual normal things you usually speak on.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then, you know, I mean, what do you think? How do you think your, what's your take or what's your thoughts on perhaps the influence you have on the society? I mean, since you started your work as regards this da'wah you're doing. So what do you think? Like, what's your influence? How have you been able to impact? I mean, yeah, I want to get your own personal view. How have you been able to impact? How have you been able to, by speaking, you know, via different mediums, different social medias, how has that been, you know, been able to go into effect? How is your goal? I mean, your goal, how has that been achieved? Have people taken what you've said into consideration? Or do you think people have taken that into consideration? Or do you think people will take it into consideration?
Well, alhamdulillah, like we said, usually they are positive, negative. But alhamdulillah, I usually see comments and I usually tell my friends from among the comments I see, the ones that really inspire me or motivate me are ones like when I see someone say, like, I think one yesterday or 2 days back, I saw someone saying, I am 53 years old and I follow what you do and I'm inspired and alhamdulillah, I'm benefiting. So that's one. When I see older people saying they are benefiting, I'm really happy and I thank Allah. Then another thing is when I see non-Muslims, yes, I do see non-Muslims, a sister or someone would say, I am a Christian, but I follow and I benefit. So this kind of comments usually inspire me and, you know, give me the, how should, what should I use to carry on and to move on and to continue.
I mean, yeah, that's a pretty
comments. Yes.
That's a pretty good reason. I mean, when you've got someone who's like 53, I mean, an older person, you know, trying to tell you that whatever you're doing, I like it. It's impact. I mean, it's having a very good impact in my life. I mean, that's motivating to the person doing the work. I also wanted to ask, you said you've got people who are from the fold of, I mean, non-Islamic faith, right? Talking to you. I mean, could you just give us an example of, I mean, because I'm curious, like, wow, someone from a non-Islamic faith.
Yes, I do see comments. They say, I am a Christian, but I follow what you do. I respect and I benefit.
Oh, yes. Nice. But then how do you think, because of course we've got a lot of friends who are non-Muslims. So how do you think we shall be, or how do you think we shall be, I mean, yeah, able to pass on the message to them? Because of course, I mean, I think it's a duty upon us too, right? To, I mean, as individuals, as Muslims, to, you know, pass on the message to those who are not Muslims.
Well, Islam is a beautiful religion.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on how you try to pass it or how you let people see it.
Yeah.
So for those who are not Muslims, non-Muslims, it depends on how you are, your relationship with them, how you treat them, how they see you do your things, and inshallah, they would be benefiting. You can't just come and start swearing or abusing or cursing just because they don't belong to the same faith. We all have to live peacefully. And yes, that's what Islam teaches. We live in peace and we give them their rights. We don't belittle them or we don't make them feel, you know, we don't make them feel like unwanted and things like that. Because the more better or the better we become in how we treat them or how we relate with them, then the better they see Islam.
Yeah.
The goodness of it.
Yeah, that's a pretty good, yeah, I think so. So, you know, like you said, it depends on your relationship with them, how you behave, how you act, you know, what they see you do and all of that, right? Those are important factors. Okay, so tell us now, what's your goal? What's your future goal? I mean, of course, we know your sole aim of doing this, to call people, share the message. I mean, that's a very important thing. But what's your own goal, your personal goal? Of course, as human beings, we should have goals. We want to be here today. We want to be there tomorrow. In the span of 10 years, I think hopefully I'll be somewhere or I will have, you know, I just want to know what's your goal? I mean, of course, you're doing very, very good work. A lot of us are jealous of you because we are not able to do it. We've just been serious here. But, you know, but what's your goal? Perhaps you might lead the way for us and perhaps we might follow behind you. So what's your own goal? What do you think is that you're doing or you're looking at, you're looking forward to, perhaps in the span of Allahu A'lam, I don't know how many years, how many months, but what's your goal? What's your, that's the most important, that's the main thing. What's your goal?
Well, the goal I have is to see that Allah uses me to spread Islam. Allah uses me to inspire people, to motivate people, no matter how little, but they should change for the better and become better people. And especially, and this is what I usually tell people,
yeah,
I don't see the benefit. Oh, yes, of course there is benefit of inspiring or motivating or changing people in a broader picture.
Yes.
But what about my own family, or what about those that are closely related to me? So this is what I usually tell people. It's not all about me going to the masajid or coming online and talking. But I really wanted to start from my home. My brothers, my sisters, my close relatives. How have I impacted on them positively? So this is my goal. So that, this is one of the things I really want in a short space of time, inshallah. I live with them. I know perhaps some things I believe should be improved on or upon. So this is what I am trying my best, and I ask Allah to help me and assist me to see that primarily my family, my relatives, those who are around, closely related, how, inshallah, I inspire them or motivate them, or inshallah, they become better people, myself included. And then, inshallah, the broader picture, the entire...
Inshallah, may Allah, make it easy and possible. Then, of course, I'll be speaking on behalf of... I mean, because, you know, the reason why I decided to come on your live this particular time, I usually, like, just come on the live and just watch. I don't want to just come on because I know you and all of that. But, I mean, I feel a lot... You know, this is poor network. Okay, good. I feel a lot of people have questions they want to ask, but they're not asking it. I mean, I'm talking about the... people with positive vibes. So, I mean, I think because when I look at your comments at times, like the way people comment, like the comment section of your posts and all of that, you get to find out or figure out when I look at the pages of those people, they are people who are also trying to share the message of Islam. I mean, I'm also trying to do that in my own way, you know, because everybody has his or her own way of doing that. So the key thing here is, I mean, I think the common factor amongst what all of us are trying to do is sharing the message of Islam. But, you know, of course, like you're the role model, the head, and, you know, but I want to know, and I'm asking on behalf of your followers, me, myself included, what do you think we shall do? What do you think we shall keep? You know, what is that to, you know, like to keep us going forward? What do you think? Okay, this is very important when you're trying to do da'wah, when you're trying to, you know, go in this path. It's not an easy task. Of course, we know. We've seen that it's not an easy task at all. But, like, tell us, okay? I mean, what's your own words of encouragement? What's your own words of advice to people who are trying to also share the message of Islam, trying to, you know, call people to Islam and all of that?
Well, like I said, I believe, number one, do your work for the sake of the Almighty.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, be very hardworking, be very dedicated, be very consistent, and don't be after followers, and know that success usually takes, you know, it takes time for you to get to the level you would want to get to in your, whatever you may be doing. And you don't compare yourself with others.
You said so.
Started today, some started 5 years ago, 10 years ago. They've reached the peak, and you just in one day want to reach where they get to. And if you see you can't reach where they've gotten to in one day, then you stop, and then you have lost because you won't carry on, and we've just lost you because you don't know how people would benefit from what you do if you had carried on with your work.
No.
So it's important. Just keep going, keep moving, keep trying, and be happy. Have good friends who would continue to motivate you to carry on with your work. Be very prayerful, make your du'as. And I believe these are things that are, inshallah, important.
Inshallah. So I hope the people in the people watching the live will keep that into consideration. And of course, I personally definitely will have to put that into consideration. I mean, you're just a message away. I could ask you again to remind me when I lost. So thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you so much. I do really appreciate it. I mean, it's very important, you know, to know all of that. So I think my questions are limited, and perhaps my questions have come to an end. So, I mean, except if you have something you want to say to me or ask me.
You've said everything already. You've said it all. This looks like some some Q&A session or some interview, subhanAllah.
Yeah, because, you know, I mean, to be honest, I've always wanted to, well, not personally, I've always wanted you to have an interview. I don't know. I recommend.
Yes, what's happening is I've gotten so many requests, so many emails from people saying they want me to come for a podcast. But right now, I haven't accepted any of the podcasts due to some reasons, but inshallah, soon. I also received emails from some of the TV channels here in Nigeria and some of the newspapers, but still I haven't accepted anyone, or I only accepted one, which I just thought would be important if I accept it for the benefit of the people. So many people have so many questions they want to be answered, so I just thought I should give that one a go. And right now I am waiting for them to contact me. They said they would get back to me, and inshallah we would be having the, I don't know, it could be a podcast or interview, but it's one of the big TV channels in Nigeria, and I believe if we do it, I believe it would be beneficial for a lot of the questions, inshallah, would be answered on the inshallah.
You know, I never knew you had something in stock. So, yeah. I mean, because that's very important, because like you said, also, a lot of people have got a lot of questions to ask you. You know, when you're at this stage in life, a lot of people want to learn, how did you get to this stage? I mean, we want to know, because, you know, so I think that's it. Yeah, I mean, it's very good that you at least accepted one of them. At least it's going to air on TV and almost everybody's going to see it. And then, you know, you that way you're able to reach more people.
And another thing why I had to accept one of them, I realized people started making videos on YouTube. Some even made some newspapers online. I saw some news, which when I went through the news, it contained false information, which I have the right to tell them to take it down, but I just said I should let go. Perhaps when I do the interview with one of those channels, it would sort or solve all of these problems.
Oh, so the false comments or false whatever was
false news information, because they don't have, I believe, enough information about myself. So they just put what they believe is right according to them.
Oh, I get it. Yeah, I mean, yes, you see, that's one of the reasons why you should accept, I mean, at least one of them, so you could clarify, or, you know, set the, okay, this is this, and, you know, just clear the air about the false news or false information going about. So, oh, yes, I remember one more question. So when do you think you're going to go, I mean, of course, you're international already because of the social media stuff, but when are you going to go international physically? Because we want to see you internationally. We want to see you go to South Africa. We want to see you go to America. We want to see you to go to the Far East, China, and all of that. So what do you think?
Well, so many people are saying, come to my country, South Africa. Don't even know so many countries. But the thing is, we can't go all. Gradually, we would go, inshallah, one after the other. But I believe from among the countries, I believe the one I am hoping to go to soon, inshallah, is South Africa.
Yes, South Africa. I mean, when you say South Africa, because a lot of people in your comment section, you know, because your role model is Mufti Meng, we all say, you're going... Mufti, we don't want you to go there. We want you to go somewhere else. We don't want two Muftis with big brains in one place. We want you to go somewhere else.
Yeah, subhanAllah, it's some reason why I have to go to South Africa.
Okay.
Yes, that's why I consider South Africa.
No, okay.
Yes, but there are other places because sometimes when I look at my YouTube page or my social networking platforms,
yeah.
Usually people would say, go to the country where you have more followers from those countries.
Yeah.
But sadly, some of the countries I can't go, or lectures cannot take place in those countries at the moment. due to some things that are happening, and we know, and the people may not know, but yes, if everything becomes better, inshallah, be able to go to those places, inshallah.
I mean, yeah, because I think we should go to somewhere like Far East Asia, because I think you have a lot of followers from, you know, Asia, India, that Pakistan, Malaysia. You've got a lot of followers from that. A lot of them. I mean, based on what I've seen on your comment section, perhaps on TikTok or something else. And then, yeah, you've got a lot of fan base in the United States, I think, too. So in the West. But, you know, but I always ask this question. Why has, I mean, that's a big question, though, but I haven't seen Mufti Menk come to, like, the Far West, particularly talking about United States. I mean, I've seen him going to London, going to different, but has he ever been there? To United States?
I think this is a question
for himself.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, because, I mean, I think it's, I haven't, I mean, well, ever since I've been, like, following up with him, I haven't really seen it. I'm like, but, yeah, let me make it easy. But hopefully you'll be there one day and you'll be all over the world, globe. I mean, it's possible to be everywhere. From here, you move there, and then you can, haven't you watched the movie, Travel Around the World in 80 Days?
I'm not into movies.
Yeah.
I don't know. Sometimes.
Okay, mashallah, it was... I really appreciate you having me here and then answering my questions. And I think perhaps I also asked a lot of questions that a lot of people will want to ask also. JazakAllah khairan, Mufti Menk. I appreciate it. May Allah bless you, bless your good work, and also help us go in the way also.
You, not Mufti Menk. You made the subhanAllah. Yes. Yes, of course.
I'm sorry. It was a big mistake. A big error from my end.
No problem. You see, people make a similar mistake. When I think yesterday or 2 days ago, I met someone. Mm-hmm. So when she saw me, I believe she doesn't know or she forgot the name. So she just said, Mufti Menk. And I was like, I just let go.
Yeah, I get it. I mean, I think it's just because... you know, just like the fame Mufti Menk has, everybody knows Mufti Menk, and then because you have the Mufti, and then perhaps, you know, you guys have a lot of things in common. So other people just Mufti, and then perhaps maybe Mufti Menk comes first from their mouth or something. I mean, I didn't even imagine I said Mufti Menk, but we make mistakes.
Yeah. Mashallah, tabarakallah. To you, and yeah, I believe this is a beautiful session. I've answered so many questions I wouldn't have answered or spoken about on a normal occasion, but
yeah,
it's been alhamdulillah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I appreciate it. It's an honor for me to be the one to ask you those questions, and perhaps you gave your own answers. I really appreciate it. It's an honor for me. I appreciate it deeply hearted. So I think I'll exit the live now for perhaps others to join or something. Yeah. Inshallah. JazakAllah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.